Hello my beauties, welcome back to my channel. This is Mibi here again with another video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you all how I made this stunning Ashoke braided headband. So I got a question from one of my lovers on here. She told me that she wanted to know how to make a headband that is braided using Ashoke. And like I always tell you guys, I'm here for you all. So I went ahead to film this video specially for her, and I decided to also share with my other lovers. So in case you're interested in knowing how to also make a braided headband that is made out of Ashoke, be sure to watch the video to the end, like the video, share with your friends, and all that good stuff. Alright guys, so you need your satin fabric. You also need your Ashoke. Feel free to use any other fabric that you are planning to use for your headband if you don't want to use Ashoke. You also need your velvet ribbon or your regular satin ribbon. You need your plastic headband as well. You also need a tape rule for measurements. You need your scissors. You also need your chalk for marking measurements. You need your glue gun. To start with, you are going to start by measuring the length of your headband. For my own headband, my headband was 14 inches wide, but because we are going for a braided headband, right, chances are I can't cut that exact measurement, right? So I went ahead to add 10 inches to the size of my headband. Because of the braiding effect that the headband is going to have, make sure that you cut 10 extra inches to the regular length of your headband. After I went ahead to cut 10 extra inches, I found that I was a bit small, so I think I'll advise I cut double the length of your headband, right? So if your headband is 14 inches, cut a fabric that is 28 inches long. So after cutting the fabric that I required for it, I went ahead to give it a good press and just folded the two edges the way I'm folding right now. So you fold the two edges, take your Ashoke to your ironing board, and then give it a good press. Fold it the way I'm folding. I don't know how to describe it for you guys, but just watch me. The way I folded it, this is how you're going to fold this and then take it to your ironing board, and then give the Ashoke a good press. So once you are done giving it a good press like this, so what it's supposed to look like after you press your Ashoke really, really well and make it very flat, it's now time for us to do the braiding that will give us that braided effect that we are going for. For an extra step, you can feel free to also, after ironing like this, also run your sewing machine on top of this fold just to secure it more, but it still doesn't make any difference because I didn't run my machine on my own. But if you want to just give yourself extra security, feel free to do that. I only went ahead to join the three Ashoke that I already ironed. I joined them together to give me three pieces of fabric because we are braiding, right? So you need three pieces in order to braid your Ashoke. And because I don't have someone to hold it for me, I decided to just sellotape, or is it paste? I don't even know. I just decided to use sellotape to hold my Ashoke onto the table where I normally do my DIY tutorials, and then I started braiding. That's my own like hack right there, just in case you're the only one and there's no one to hold your Ashoke for you to braid. Just improvise basically in order to make things work. This is the braiding that I first of all did, and then I went ahead to wrap my plastic headband with this satin fabric. Because I didn't have enough Ashoke, I could have used my Ashoke as well to wrap the headband, but because I didn't have enough Ashoke, I decided to use a satin fabric to wrap the headband. Just in case you don't know how to wrap a headband with fabric, I have another tutorial that is more in-depth than this. I'm going to link that on the screen for you guys. So I found out that I didn't like the fact that my braiding was very, very loose. I wanted to, you know, try to do a loose kind of braid and see what it looked like. But because, like I said, I didn't cut enough fabric, the Ashoke was not going around on my headband. So I had to tighten my braid in order for it to be long enough to cover the entire headband that I already wrapped now. So I'm talking about the plastic headband that I wrapped. So that's why I'm braiding the Ashoke all over again. And after doing that, this is what we have now. What I'm doing now is I'm securing the Ashoke, the braided Ashoke now. I'm securing it onto the plastic headband by just using my thread to just tie it at the edges, right? So I'm going to put the entire length of the braided headband that I already did, and then I'm going to, from end to end, just the way I did here, I'm doing this now for the other end of the plastic headband, just tying it down to make sure that it doesn't move around. And after doing this, because you know now I'm the queen of security, I always like things being very, very secure, I'm going to go ahead to do a little bit of sewing here just to sew down the braided Ashoke onto the headband and make sure that it doesn't move out of place. So just watch me as I go along. Is this your first time of coming to my channel, welcome. I want to just encourage you to go ahead to hit the subscribe button. I'm trying to grow my channel up to 2,000 subscribers. That's my goal for the month of May. And I really, really would love your help in achieving that milestone. So if you're yet to hit the subscribe button, please do well to hit the subscribe button. Also, give the video a thumbs up if you're enjoying the video. So what I'm doing now is I'm covering the edge of my headband. So I went ahead to just sew a little piece of Ashoke just to be able to cover the raw edges of my headband to give it a very, very neat look at the end. And that's what I'm sewing onto the edge of my Ashoke. For this part, feel free to use a ribbon or something. You don't have to use Ashoke, right? This is just me. I just came up with this idea in my head. So you don't have to do the exact same thing. If you don't have enough Ashoke, feel free to use ribbon or any other fabric. Just be creative with any one of your own personal DIY tutorials that you do at home. So this is what the headband looks like now. I'm done, you know, sewing it down and covering up the raw edges. That's the ends of the headband. And this is the final look of the headband. But because I'm an extra girl, I didn't want my headband to just be plain like this. I went ahead to basically embellish it, and I'm using these beads that I have on here. These beads were from a previous outfit that I made that I just didn't like the way it looked with this bead, so I removed all the beads that I placed on it, and now I'm using them for another purpose, right? I'm using them to embellish this my headband right here. You can just skip this step, right? If you don't have beads or if you're not interested in using beads on yours, just skip this step. This is just me being extra. So after embellishing and everything, this is what my headband looks like. Let me know, do you prefer the headband without beads or do you like it with the beads? Drop it down in the comment section and let me just know what you guys think. So this is me. I went ahead to do my makeup and I'm just here to show you guys how the headband looks on me, just to give you guys an imagination of what it will look on you. And voila, this is it on me. It looks absolutely stunning. Thank you for the suggestion from my friend on here. Thank you so much for that suggestion. This headband came out looking really, really stunning, and I wore it out and I got a lot of compliments. And I'm sure when you guys go ahead to make one for yourselves as well, you're going to keep getting compliments as well. So this is the end of the video right here. I'm just going to please beg you guys again to hit the subscribe button if you're still yet to hit the subscribe button. Also, share the video with your friends. Sharing is good, okay? There's love in sharing, so please be sure to hit the share button and share with your friends that love to do DIY stuff at home or anywhere they are, basically. Also, give the video a big fat thumbs up if you enjoyed watching. I'm sure you thoroughly enjoyed watching if you made it up to this point in the video. So be sure to hit the like button. I'm going to leave some videos on the screen. Please be sure to watch something. And yeah, I can't wait to see you guys in my next video. Bye. Mwah.